Hey everybody, I hope you're having a lovely day today. Welcome to Genial Cymru. My name is Di, and here we talk about genealogy and Welsh history. If you're interested in any of that, there's a subscribe button at the bottom right of your screen. I started working on my family tree back in January of 2020, and to be perfectly honest, I didn't think I'd find much of anything. I'm at the point now, a year and a half later, where I've got over 18,000 records, just about members of my family. This includes photographs, articles, wills, baptisms, marriages, burials, stories from relatives, and many other types of records. I started off my research with just one big folder on my computer where I would throw all of my records and figure it out later. Soon that became really unsustainable. But over the past year and a half, I've developed strategies that have helped me organize my record in a way that's really helpful. So in today's video, we're going to talk about some of those strategies so that you can use them as you go about creating your own personal genealogy archive. The place where we start when creating our own personal genealogy archive is with saving the records. It's important that you save a copy of all of the records that you find on the online databases. There's a couple different ways that you can do that, and with some of the websites like Ancestry, they have a function that allows you to just download the record to your computer. What I also like to do in some of the places that don't have this option is just use a snipping tool. You can take a clip of any page that you're looking at, and then you can include even the address bar or any of the bibliographic information so that you can go back and find it if you ever need to. Or you can just do a print screen by using your keyboard. No matter what method you use, it's important to save a copy of the record to your computer. Some of the genealogy websites, like Ancestry, allow you to save a record to a person in your online family tree, and that pin function can be really helpful in many ways, but it's still important that you save that copy of the record to your own computer as well. If you're in the online genealogy spaces for any time, you'll soon find horror stories of people losing their online trees and decades of their work. The tree might just disappear, you might lose access to your account, and it's devastating. It's also important to know that if your Ancestry subscription runs out, you won't be able to view those records even if you've pinned them to your tree. So again, make sure that you're saving your records to your computer. And now that you're saving records to your computer and you've found one, what do you name it? The thing that I've learned is that it's important to name them something that will be helpful to you in the long run. You want to be able to look at it and know exactly what it is. When I started off with that one big messy folder where I just threw all of my files, I was naming them as follows. Surname, name, year, and record type. So I would come out of that with something that looks like this. Williams, William, 1851, census. So if you've been working on your family tree for any time at all, and especially if you're doing Welsh genealogy, you might see a problem with this. I soon realized just how faithfully my ancestors were passing down personal names generation after generation. And on top of that, there's very little surname diversity in Wales, and also in my family tree. In my case, I'm descended from 6 different, unrelated Davis families. If I was saving a record for David Davis or John Davis, how many 1851 census might I have? Too many, far too many. What I noticed was that I was trying to give all of these different records the exact same name, and that doesn't work. Even when I was able to save a record in this way, I look back at the records now and go, oh, David Davis, but which one? And this strategy just wasn't working when I was trying to make a clear, organized archive. So how am I doing it now? Now I write the surname, the name, the year, the record type, plus their ancestry and a place. What my files end up looking like now are something like this. Richards, James Augustus, 1906, burial, son of Mary, daughter of Timothy, son of Thomas, son of David, Mary, Thomas, Olwen. And when I look through my folders of these 18,000 records now, for each of my files, I've given myself a map to be able to find that person in my tree without having to even open the record. If you're just starting out your tree, you can always make the ancestry part of the file point back to yourself. So for me, I might write something like Morgan, Mary, 1822, baptism, mother of William, father of Thomas, father of Thomas John, father of Grampy, father of Mum, mother of me. The other way that I've done it before is by pointing back to ancestors that naturally stand out to me. One of those is my four times great-grandmother, Esther Thomas. So when I'm doing research for my Thomas tree, I might point myself back to her when saving the files. Now that we have a name for our files, where do we actually save them? For each of my family lines, I create a separate folder. And we're trying to do the same thing that we're doing with each file, and that is naming the folder something that is helpful to us and gives us all the information that we need at a glance. So in my case, with six different Davis lineages that I'm descended from, I include the place that they're from or that I associate them with. With that, I have a Davis Olwen folder, and I have a Davis Llandeby folder, etc., etc. And when I find records, I generally just put them all in this main family lineage folder. Sometimes I just want to search and collect, and then leave the family tree part till later. Once I start going through these files, I start filtering them into subfolders. What works best for me is having a subfolder for photographs, one for articles, one for wills, one for probable, and another for processed. Most of these are self-explanatory, but I wanted to explain what I mean by probable and what I mean by processed. So the probable folder gets every record that I'm kind of unsure of. I think it might be connected, but I haven't found the connection yet. Maybe it's people living at the same farm at a later date, or maybe it's people with similar names. Maybe they're related, but maybe not. Maybe I just don't have enough info, and I'm just waiting for that one last piece of the puzzle. Whatever that situation might be, they all get put into my probable folder until I find the answer to my question. With the processed folder, that's the final destination for all of my records. By processing, I mean taking that record with all of its raw data, making it into something that then presents your findings. For most people, that's your visual family tree. Other people might write small biographies for each person, or even short stories about their lives. For me, it's the visual family tree. And once I take all of the information from the records and put it into my tree, I put that record into the processed folder. With newspapers and journal articles, which you can get on the National Library of Wales website, I save a screenshot of each of them and save it into the folder. Over time, 15 minutes a day, I type them up into a Word document. That way, they become more readable, and I can search specific words if I want to. It's especially helpful for Welsh language articles, so I can take the transcription and stick it into Google Translate to see it in English. Or, again, little by little, I can go about translating it by myself. And once all of that happens, and the information in the article gets put into my family tree, I send it to the processed folder that I have specifically for my journal articles. The last thing that I'm going to talk about is probably the most important and will save you from the most heartache. Back up your data, please. Back up your data. So many things are out of our control when it comes to technology. Computers die, drinks get spilled on them, they get knocked to the floor and smash. In my own family, we had a big genealogy loss about 15 years ago. My grampy worked a lot on the family history, and then the house was struck by lightning. It fried every piece of electronics in the house, and he lost everything that hadn't been written down by hand. There's a couple different ways that you can back up your data. USB drives are always really handy. You plug them into your computer, and they can save about 2 gigabytes of data. What 2 gigabytes means in terms of records, for me, is about 2,400 files. Also, there's external hard drives that can hold hundreds of thousands of files, almost an infinite amount, but they can be really expensive. But I want to save you some money, so there are some free options. Dropbox, with a free account, you can save, again, 2 gigabytes of data. Or if you get an Outlook email account, you can get a free personal OneDrive that saves about 5 gigabytes. These are great because even if something bad happens to your computer, all of your information gets saved online. And as long as you have access to that account and the internet, you can access your files from anywhere. That sounded a lot like an ad, but I promise you it's not. I really just want all of your hard work that you do for your research to be safe. But that's about it. And I know for many of us, the goal is to eventually start sharing our research findings with our family, or even pass our research project down to our descendants, or maybe even publish our work in one of the many family history journals. In all of these cases, making sure that you have a clearly organized archive will help. It'll make it easier for yourself and for others who might want to continue our research after us. If you have any strategies that you use, please let me know in the comments. Whatever works for you, I'd love to hear about it. If you'd like to see more genealogy or Welsh history videos, please make sure to hit the subscribe button. If you'd like to support this channel or get access to exclusive content, check out the Patreon and join the newsletter. You can also follow us on most platforms just by searching Genial Cymru. Thanks for watching.